Hello and welcome. Today we talk about temperature problems in a Volkswagen Polo 9N coolant temperature. So you might have seen this, you're driving and out of the blue the temperature warning sign starts to show. It's really uncomfortable to drive like this, and also especially if you're on the highway. So yeah, that needs to be addressed immediately. So the thing to do is to actually stop. You need to stop when you see this immediately. The reason why I say you need to stop is because this might be an actual overheating temp problem with the engine, and that could lead to engine damage. Yeah, you don't want that for sure. So you need to make sure that this is not a problem with the coolant temperature getting too high. This is the main priority. So what I did here, to make sure that this is real, I put the heater on full heating in the car, and also I wanted to make sure that the temperature still shows even after stopping the engine. And I left the car sitting for about half hour. It doesn't show here, but I did this, and the temperature of the coolant was lower, but I still got a warning. So that was a good thing. It meant it's not related to the actual temperature, but to the level of the coolant, which is one of the first things you should check if you're on the road. If you have a leak in the radiator or some problem with the pressure in the cooling, you see that it just came up again. Here the coolant temperature is normal, but this does it every time, even if the engine is completely cold. That's really good, because it means it's a problem with the level of the coolant in the expansion tank. And if you check that level and the level is right, it's not low, then that's a very easy thing to fix. It's just a sensor of the coolant level, basically. But you want to be sure. One of the signs that is that sensor, and it's not an engine failure. I mean, not engine failure, but this could cause a problem that it would get oil and coolant mixed together because of the way the engine is built. Now it's taking its time to start the error. As you see, it's not an error, it's a warning sign. And the beeping is really, it's really not nice to hear that. So if you realize that the temperature of the coolant is not the problem, and the coolant level is at the right level, and it's most probably just the sensor, you can safely drive home with this without any issues. It's annoying to see the light, but you can drive home like this. So here I'm still waiting for the warning sign, and it will show up eventually. Just trying to rev up the engine a little bit to move the car a bit, but still it comes up. If this is the problem you have, then it's a very easy thing to do. It's very cheap, very easy to either you change the expansion tank, the coolant expansion tank, if the sensor is damaged, or you just clean the connectors. That's it. Yeah, there it is. The other option was to basically remove half of the engine and replace a part on it. And yeah, head gasket, that's called the head gasket. And if that the engine overheats, that's a big problem. It's expensive to fix because it's a lot of work, and you don't want that. Another clue about this is that this, if it happens in the winter, it's less likely to be overheating. If it happens in the summer, it's more likely to be overheating, and you need to stop the car, let it cool down, and then continue to drive. Here the coolant level is a bit high, but nothing really to be concerned about. So this cap is a bit too tight, you see it's making some marks there. First thing to do when you open the coolant expansion tank, just touch a bit of the coolant with your fingers. Make sure it's not oily.
No oil.
That's not oily, so that's perfect. It means there is no oil in the coolant. The oil and coolant don't mix, and means the head gasket is pretty good. Nice to drive. That's great. If the coolant overheats and you don't stop and you keep driving, then the head gasket would not survive this and it needs to be replaced. So the problem in this case is on somewhere in this connection or inside the sensor, and I need to find out how to make this work without changing the actual tank, because I changed this expansion tank and this is not original, so maybe that's why it's not working so great. That's the coolant. You can check the car. Mine is not great, I need to change it actually. So first thing I do, I take a multimeter and I just put the probes in the coolant to measure the actual resistance between the probes while they're in the coolant. So that's like a reference for me to know where it should be. That's about 15 mega ohms, I think it's mega ohms, 10 mega ohms. So I need to know that anyway, any resistance, that anything, any reading that you see on this, it's good. It means that the probe is working, but I did this just to make sure on which range to set the multimeter. So I set it on the highest rating, To remove the connector, you just press on the clip. That's it, only two connectors, two terminals. It doesn't look bad here, but if you really take your camera phone and check there is a bit of rust. That shouldn't really be like that, so I don't know if the rust is inside the expansion tank or if it's just the connector. I'm trying to put these terminals put the probes of the multimeter between the terminals and I get no reading. There's nothing. Maybe I didn't do it right, I'm not sure, but anyway, actually it should work with this. Maybe I didn't put them in the right place. The thing you need to do as soon as you see any rust in here, just take a bottle of WD-40 and just spray it like crazy, but make sure you don't get any of that WD-40 inside the actual coolant. So you have to do it with the cap closed. Close the cap of the coolant expansion tank. Get one WD-40 with the straw like this, so it's easy to spray, and just spray as much as you want, but okay, maybe not too much, because all you need is to spray a little, let it sit for 5-10 minutes, then spray again a few times, and in the connector also this way. The idea is that the WD-40 will kind of melt the rust away, so that the rust will get dissolved. And the nice thing about this is that with WD-40, I think other cleaners also, it's safe to reconnect the electrical terminal without really cleaning it too much. So that's nice because it keeps the water outside, keeps the water away. That's the actual thing that it's doing, keeps the water away. Here I'm cleaning with a bit of paper, just trying to rub as much of this paper on the terminals to remove the rust. And you can see there is some rust coming out, so yeah, that seems to be working pretty well. Trying again this the same thing, and it's a bit difficult to get a reading. Maybe there was a better way to do it, but I didn't really want to spend too much time on this. And of course, the multimeter turns off at the wrong time, because I was trying really hard to do this. So yeah, eventually it worked, but I think it worked, yeah. So sometimes it's working, sometimes it's not. I think just because I was pressing it, but it's better if you do this multiple times, clean with WD-40 2-3 times at least, to make sure that those terminals are in great shape. One more thing to do once you when you clean it, it's good to connect and reconnect, remove the connector a few times to make sure that the surface is clean. And this you can do between the sprays, so you can connect it, spray it with WD-40, connect it, reconnect, remove it, connect it, remove it a few times like this. It also helps to clean the contacts. Okay, so that's finished, hopefully. Anyway, I know it's finished because it's done, it worked. So, first test, it's pretty dusty in the car, so sorry about that. And the engine is started, it's cold, but yeah, just trying to clean up a little bit. Yep. So there is a bit of that light there, it's kind of showing. It went away afterwards. I don't know if it was because of the sensor, if it was something else, or the cold. I don't know, it just it was very dim and then it went away. Hopefully it's not gonna be a problem with the steering wheel, but okay, let's see. We'll see later. Yeah, it's been some time starting it, no problems. Now the temperature is higher. I have no temperature warning. Only thing I did was clean the contact. I didn't have to replace the coolant expansion tank. I didn't have to even change the cooler. I might have to do that. But yeah, this is the one thing to do. But be careful if you do this. You do this only when you know for sure this is the problem. You can keep driving. Otherwise, stop the car, let it cool down, and when it's cool, if it's still doing it, if you still see the temperature and the coolant level is right, then it's the sensor. If it cools down and it's not doing it immediately, then you know it's actually an engine overheating, and that's a more complicated problem. For that, it needs to go to a service, to a mechanic, to make sure that actually to see if it's worth it to replace it. Usually it is. Thanks for watching, and I hope you like this video, and happy new year for 2020. Have a great year. Subscribe, like and share, and I'll see you next time. Bye.